Dear students, welcome to the next topic, parallel processing. What is parallel processing? Parallel processing is simultaneous data processing, concurrent execution of instructions. Why do we do this parallel processing? The purpose of parallel processing is to speed up and increase the throughput. What is throughput? The amount of processing that can be accomplished during a given interval of time. And in order to increase this throughput, obviously the amount of hardware required will be increased, and that increases the cost of the system. Parallel processing can be seen at various levels of complexity. At lowest level, you can look at shift registers. There are different types of shift registers, serial input, serial output, or parallel input, parallel output. In serial input, serial output register, shift register, you can see one bit at a time will be coming out of the register, whereas in the parallel input parallel output register with parallel load capability can send multiple number of bits at a time depending upon the number of bits that are stored in the register. At a higher level of complexity, you need multiplicity of functional units. Parallel processing can be seen as distributing the data among the multiple functional units. For example, ALU, arithmetic, logical and shift units. ALU is a centralized functional unit which can do arithmetic, logical and shift operations, but one at a time. If you have to do three different operations, one arithmetic operation, one logical operation, one shift operation, you cannot do all these three with the help of ALU at a time. You need to wait. After the arithmetic operation is over, then you will do logical operation. After the logical operation is over, you will do shift operation. Okay, this wait can be removed if the functional unit is decentralized. Here you can see a processor with multiple functional units. It is having a separate adder, subtractor, integer multiply, logic unit, shift unit, incrementer, and floating operations. Here the processor registers are there. You need a control unit to coordinate these operations. Okay, all you need to provide is separate operands. They all need separate operands. They need different data. They cannot act on same data at a time, because you can use the memory. Data will be stored in the memory, and one data can be used by one functional unit. The same data cannot be used by all the functional units. For that, you need to have separate modules in the memory. Okay, that is different issue. We'll discuss about it later. Right now, parallel processing can be accomplished by having individual independent functional units. Okay, as I told you, ALU is a centralized functional unit which is having many capabilities, but all the capabilities cannot be utilized at a time. In this kind of structure, you can use all these individual functional units at a time. Only thing you need to do is provide the different data. Now, how to classify the parallel processing systems? Parallel processing systems can be classified in different ways based on the internal organization of processor or interconnection structure or the flow of information through the system. Here we are going to look at MJ Flynn's classification. He had classified all the computers into four categories: SISD, SIMD, MISD, MIMD. So what is this SISD, SIMD, MISD and MIMD? Single instruction stream, single data stream, single instruction stream, multiple data stream, multiple instruction stream, single data stream, multiple instruction stream, multiple data stream. So here the common things are instruction stream and data stream. So you should know the meaning of instruction stream and data stream, then only you will understand this Dr. M.J. Flynn's classification of computers, parallel processors. So first of all, instruction stream means sequence of instructions read from memory. Sequence of instructions read from memory. Okay, these instructions will be executed. Okay, but these instructions are stored in the memory. So these instructions must be read from memory or memory module. Now come to the data stream. Operations performed on the data in the processor. So those instructions are going to be executed on some operands or data, and that will be happening in a processor. So here you need memory or memory module, here you need a processor. Okay. Now these four systems, SISD, SIMD, MISD, MIMD, are shown like this. Let us start with SIMD. Single instruction stream, single data stream. That means this kind of parallel processor will be having single memory unit and single processor. Okay. From that single memory unit, the instructions, sequence of instructions will be read and then executed in the processor. Now come to SIMD, single instruction stream, multiple data stream. That means you will be having a shared memory which is having multiple memory modules. Okay, from those memory modules, different processors will be receiving instruction streams. Okay, in this SIMD processor, you will have a shared memory unit and multiple processors. From the shared memory unit, which is having sub memory modules, all these processors will be receiving stream of instructions, and they will be executed in these multiple processors. Now let's come to MISD, multiple instruction stream, single data stream. This kind of computer is not made till now. It is just for theoretical purposes. There is no such computer which can execute multiple instructions received from multiple memory units. Okay. Let's go to the last one, MIMD, multiple instruction stream, multiple data stream. Okay. Multiple instruction stream requires multiple memory units. Okay. And multiple data stream means multiple processors. So these processors will be receiving instructions from different memory units, and they will be executed in different processors. Okay. So for this parallel processing, one thing is very much important, that is a complex control unit to coordinate between these memory units and the processors. Without that complex control unit, it is impossible to achieve this parallel processing. Okay. Why are we insisting on the parallel processing? Because parallel processing reduces the time. Serial processing takes more time. Parallel processing reduces the time and increases the throughput. Okay. Thank you.